Hello, everyone! It is Sunday, May 19th in the year of our Lord 2013. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. Hey, it may be Sunday, Gospel Sunday, Sacrificial Sunday, but it's only five more days to Friday, and that is A-OK to me. And today's show, you know beer is good for you, and that's what it's all about, baby. Beer, songs, hunks, babes, all kinds of good stuff. Trivia. And, of course, my unofficial sponsor for today, The Ravel. That's T-H-E-R-A-V-E-L. The Ravel. Look it up on Facebook. Look it up on theravel.com, all one word. My good friends Johnny and his better half, Emma Montgomery, who I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. That's Johnny's website, and he basically, you know, you unravel some stories, stuff like that. Lots of good posts out there. The Ravel on Facebook hadn't been very active lately. So we gotta work on that, folks. Okay? Help us out. With that said, I'm parched and I need beer. Proper beer consumption apparatus. It is Sunday, so why not? As we bring out one I have yet to bring out on this here show before. I haven't had it before. Victory Storm King Imperial Stout out of Downington, Pennsylvania. And folks, would you look at these. Alcohol by volume on that. 9.1%. Ooh, baby. That's a beast of a beer right there. Truly a meal in the bottle. Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. And a so-so pop. Beer is good for you. 45 degree angle right into the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. I probably shouldn't drink a beer like this when it's 96 degrees outside, but I'm a fruitcake, so it doesn't matter. It's all about flavor, baby. Cheers and beer to all you prosses, saying Germany come pie, as they say in Japan. I'm giving this one a B+. An awesome beer indeed. A little stronger on the mouthfeel, the aftertaste, a little there. A little dark, you know, kind of like black, but other than that, this beer is phenomenal. And I like dark beer, so you may not like it. If you don't like dark beers, this one probably is one you won't like. But you never know. Don't knock it till you try it. That's what it's all about. That's why I feature different beers as much as possible. We got a lot of birthdays to get to. Let's get cracking. My good friend Aaron Borchard, a badass crew dog I know in jolly old England. He used to live here. He's actually from down here in Yeehaw, Texas, where men and the bulls run scared. Aaron Borchard, happy birthday to you, my brother from another mother. Oh, shoot, I just realized something. I'm looking at yesterday's notes. Hey, Aaron, how you doing, huh? Happy birthday yesterday. Whoops. Hey, nobody perfect, but I was perfect. I'd be playing third base for the Red Sox. Let's give a shout-out to a pair of brothers, Jim and Andrew Young. Happy birthday to you. Hope you're doing well. I don't know you guys in person. Just added you recently. Strays Fight United, Mafia Wars. Awesome, awesome family. The best family on Mafia Wars, I might add. But, hey, hope you guys have a phenomenal day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And a big hearty cheers and beers to you. This is the show I was talking about on our Strays Fight United lounge page, okay? So, hey, here you go. The Love Doctor on Mafia Wars. That's this guy. Alrighty, next on the list, this guy I know and I know really well, Cold Miser, Gonzo, you crazy son bitch, how you doing, happy birthday to you, a badass jetsicle I worked with in jolly old England, doing great things, he loves the Cowboys like he loves getting kicked in the face with a steel-toed boot, and we're always talking sports, Gonzo, brother, I wish you could be here right now, co-hosting with me on this here show. Brother, always a pleasure chatting with you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969. Minus the acid. Hope you have a wicked awesome day, brother. Next on the list. Now, we got our lady admin, the lovely Sarah Milligan. She's our art director, our executive director of the show. Runs the babe, the Hunk of the Day album for you. And, oh yes, she's also the graphic designer. Well, Sarah, today is your better half, Matt Milligan's birthday. He's a badass crew dog that I worked with in jolly old England. Matt, much love to you, buddy. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I know you love your Cowboys. He's a true Texas guy, no doubt about it. Hey, you do realize, though, Matt, right? Texas is just western Louisiana. I mean, come on. Really? Matt, hope you enjoy the show. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Say, baby, you take care of your wonderful man. He's a damn good guy. And you guys have a wicked awesome day. Squeeze me. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate. Celebrate well. All right. And Matt, be sure to watch the May 18th episode of Beer and Song of the Day. We did Tombstone just for you, buddy, as a birthday gift. All right? There you go, Tombstone. A movie I haven't seen yet, but I want to see it now because shame on me for never seeing that movie before. After doing yesterday's show, made me realize, damn, I got to see that movie. All right, next on the list. Speaking of Strays Fight United, the best damn Mafia Wars family in the world on the old Facebook, my good friend Cathy Hike. Happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Thank you, as always, for all your great help. Been chatting with you for over 2 years. Just an awesome, awesome mafiaette, an awesome lady, an awesome friend. And Cathy, I hope you have an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And a big cheers and beers to you. Hope you enjoy the show. Next on the list, my man Justin Daly. Another badass crew dog I worked with in jolly old England. Justin, how's life treating you, my friend? Hope you're doing well. Always a pleasure, man. Heard from you not too long ago, actually. It's always good. And hope you watch the show. Hope you say, man, that Dr. B's a crazy son bitch. Well, you know what? I am. Hey, what's normal anyway, right? Exactly. Well, hey, you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Have an adult beverage. That's what I'm doing. Drinking here, right now with you and all you other birthday folks. So hope you have a phenomenal day. Celebrate well and enjoy. All right, next on the list, my man Dewayne Jackson. This guy's ultra cool. What he does is he plans out and schedules jobs and things like that on the job site. Really cool stuff. Planners like Dewayne, we need them. I'm telling you. Dewayne, dude, it was a pleasure and an honor hanging out with you in Bible camp a couple years ago. We found God, learned lots of scripture. And oh, yes, we did learn a little bit about the old adult beverages too, huh? And you know something, Dewayne? I love you, bud. But man, am I glad those Lakers aren't in the playoffs. Ha! I'll drink to that. But hey, seriously, happy birthday to you, my friend. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Alrighty, did we burn through all the birthdays? By golly, we did. How about some additional shout-outs? May 19th is a very important day to me. Because back on May 19th, 1990, my junior prom, I took a lovely lady there with me. The theme of the prom was, We've Got Tonight. That's right, Kenny Rogers, baby. But hey, this lovely lady, Luanna Hathaway. Lulu, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. You still look fantabulous. Absolutely gorgeous. Total sweetheart of a lady. And thank you so much for being my date for the prom. That was totally awesome. And always a pleasure hearing from you and your mom, the wonderful Jessica. Great lady. Jessica, thank you so much for hooking us up with that 88 Mustang convertible. Oh, that was fun. God, that was a good time. But, Lulu, I hope you enjoy the show, and I hope you have a wicked awesome day, and just celebrate life, and happy anniversary. I can't believe it's been 23 years since the junior prom. Wow, I feel old. Hey, I'd rather be old than dead. That's right. And then, a couple years ago today, I got a job promotion. Yes, I did. And I found out while I was hanging out in Bible camp. And I had three very good friends of mine. We had my man, Dr. Alan Brown, my old man, Larissa Lillard, and my big badass man, Ryan Forrest. A badass crew dog that I worked with in jolly old England. He's living in Oklahoma, otherwise known as Northern Texas. And Ryan being a Texas man, I know you can appreciate that. Ryan, dude, my friend, always a pleasure chatting with you, man. And thank you for being there that day 2 years ago. We found out at 3:05 p.m., busted out that Chimay Blue, big-ass bottle, 9%, passed that sucker around. Dude, that made my day. That made my trip. Bible camp was totally wicked awesome. And so are you, a true friend indeed. Definitely a pleasure. And brother, cheers and beers to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Enjoy the show, and I'll be praying for you. I know Oklahoma's got some crazy-ass weather right now. That's the Midwest for you. But makes it exciting, doesn't it? Ryan, much love to you, brother. No homo. Cheers and beers. Have a drink with me, all right, would you? Jackass. Cheers and beers, brother. All righty. Sadly, I haven't heard from the other two in a long, long time. But I do know that Larissa is extremely pregnant. Wow. Maybe the baby will be born on my birthday, June 27th. You never know. But with that said, let's press on. We've got one more shout-out, and I'm going to save that for a moment. We're going to give her a shout-out as we unleash today's hunk of the day. Oh, wait. Let's go ahead and do that now. Why not? My lovely friend Michelle Nix, who I met in good old Germany. She's the better half of my good friend Mike Nix, who I worked with in good old California, the land of fruits and nuts, better known as Western Nevada. Michelle, a sweetheart of a lady living in Washington State, last checked. And she's a wicked hardcore Wisconsin Badgers fan, and she's also a fan of this man right here. Michelle, squeeze me. Hey, I finally am fulfilling your request because you are very active on the page, on the Beard Song of the Day page. Thank you so much for that. Michelle, I give you a Love Doctor salute. We're going to unleash that man for you, Russell Wilson. Oh, yeah, there you go. Hey, Russell Wilson, number 3, Seattle Seahawks quarterback, badass. There you go, huh? You're loving this, aren't you, Michelle? Hey, Mike, don't get upset. Don't worry. She ain't going to leave you, all right? At least I don't think so. Hey, besides, Russell Wilson's married. Look at his better half, huh? Wow, what? Oh, I will just shut up now. I'm not going to say anything because I might get in trouble. What a mouth. All right. With that said, how about some additional celebrity birthdays as we let you ladies and you men that love the men drool over Russell Wilson. We've got Sean Paul. He's 49 years old today. Pete Townshend of The Who. Phenomenal rock band. British rock band. Pete Townshend, would you believe that he is 68 years old today? He showed up is. How about a shout out to the late, great Malcolm X. Born on this day in 1925, sadly was murdered in 1965, just short of 40 years old. His message rang loud and clear, and I'll tell you what, he was all about equality for everyone, which I am as well. He had a pretty hardcore way of doing things, but, you know, a lot of people were angry back in those days. And you know what? I can understand that. I really can. Because that was a bunch of crap with what some people had to go through. We are all equal. Equally worthwhile, equally worthless, however you want to put it, you know. And thank God, I'm sure greats like Malcolm X and the late great Reverend Dr. Martin Luther the King are smiling right now knowing that our country has improved a lot when it comes to equality. And we still got ways to go, but hey, we're getting there, folks. We're getting there. How about Kevin Garnett, Boston Celtic? Badass! That's right, Kevin Garnett. He is 37 years old today, formerly very well known with the Minnesota Timberwolves. And then we got Andre the Giant. Badass wrestler back in the day, 7'4", 500 pounds of absolute beast from Grenoble, France. Andre the Giant, born on this day in 1946, sadly passed away, had a heart attack at his father's funeral in January 1993, died at only 46 years old. The next one, how about this lady, Grace Jones? Oh boy, I don't even know where to go with her. I'll tell you what, I think she's more of a man than I'll ever be. Whew, she's something else. Grace Jones, Strange. I can't help but think of Strange. That's right. Grace Jones, now, this source says she's 65 today. I thought she was born in 53, in which case she would be 60. But whatever the case, well, she was born in 1948, 1953. Woman's got a hell of a body, a model indeed. Pretty damn good actress, I might add. But, woo, what a tough girl she is. She was great in those Conan movies, wasn't she? I thought so. On this day in 1951, sadly passed away in 2001 at the age of 489, Joey Ramone of the Ramones brought in the punk era that we all know and love so well whether we love it or not. I do. Russell Wilson, I know the ladies love him. How about Peter Mayhew? He played Chewbacca in all those Star Wars movies. He's 69 years old today. Then we got gorgeous actress Jordan Pruitt. She's 22 and telling you, my how she's grown up. Boy, am I feeling old. This is a Justin Dimmitt moment. Justin being a fan of the Mannings. Justin, my executive producer, creator of the Baron Song of the Day Facebook page, and runs the Baby of the Day album for you, and who has just completed the Beer of the Day album. Well over 500 beers displayed. We're getting close to 600 now, okay? And Justin, dude, you're going to love Dr. Salute, man. I'm telling you. You have done amazing things with that album. Thank you so much. And Archie Manning, quarterback, New Orleans Saints. Archie Manning, the father of Peyton Manning and Eli Manning. That Manning family, I'll tell you what, they need to be fruitful and multiply, huh? They need to breed more and more quarterbacks. But Archie Manning, a damn good quarterback indeed, and a hell of a mentor to his kids. He's 64 years old today. And then you got this guy, Ferdinand Magellan. That's right, the first explorer to go around the world. And sadly, his journey started in 1519 and he died in 1521. The journey was completed by his crew in 1522. Ferdinand Magellan, born on this day in 1480, passed away in 1521, just short of 41 years old. Died at sea. There you go, huh? Danny Trejo, actor, 69 years old today, same age as Peter Mayhew. How about that? The late, great, not so great in my opinion, Ho Chi Minh, born on this day in 1890, communist bastard, died in 1969, and I'm not complaining about that. That's right. He's the reason that Vietnam is communist. Ho Chi Minh. Definitely loved by Jane Fonda, I'm sure. Bitch. On this day in 1975, London Fletcher was born. Badass for the Denver Broncos. And finally on this day in 1949, oh, we got a couple more. Dusty Hill, bass player for ZZ Top, was born. How about that? Hey, remember this game? I don't always throw interceptions, but when I do, they're game winning. Yeah, you know what? It was too, because guess what? Though it should have been an interception, it was counted as a touchdown pass, and the Green Bay Packers got screwed. Right, Michelle? You gotta admit they did. Hey, Michelle, by the way, look at that, huh? Michelle, he's giving you some roses. Aw, shit. Loving it, aren't you, girl? I know you are. Oh, one more birthday to a guy that I can't stand personally. One of my number one hated players in the NBA. Douchebag Bill Laimbeer. I know if you're a Detroit Pistons fan, you love the guy. But I'll tell you what, us Celtics fans, we couldn't stand the son of a bitch. Him, Rick Mahorn, the Bad Boys, the Worm, Dennis Rodman. You give them credit, dude. Detroit Pistons in the late 80s, early 90s, the Bad Boys. Hell of a basketball team. No doubt about it. But Bill Laimbeer, what a bitch he was, I thought. Ugh, couldn't stand him. So Bill Laimbeer, happy birthday, but still, I say that, all right? Russell Wilson, on the other hand, no GFY for him. That guy's just awesome. I really, really, really like Russell Wilson. A badass dude with a beautiful woe man for a better half. And, you know, I hope his good luck continues in the NFL. I'm rooting for the guy. Because a lot of people doubt him. He's like 5'11", you know. And he's doing great things. Keep it up there, Russell Wilson. You can do it! You can do it all night long and the ladies love you. Aw, yeah, they do. With that said, folks, I think we show off a few more pictures. Hey, look at this, Michelle. Yeah, you know that stadium, because that's Wisconsin. Or as those folks up in the northern Midwest say, Wisconsin. That's right. Badger Stadium. Mm-hmm. Russell Wilson. Stud, badass quarterback. And very much loved by his better half. Alrighty, I think it's time we roll on to the song of the day. And folks, today's Babe of the Day is so freaking gorgeous. And I would have never heard of her if it wasn't for my love goddesses novellas. What are novellas, you say? Mexican soap operas. That's right. Although this lady's actually from Puerto Rico. She plays in the Mexican soap operas. She's very popular in novellas. Before we get to her, there was a trivia question out there that I posted yesterday. Actually, I take that back. My friend, my lady admin, Say Baby, she posted it. She was busy, so I helped her out on this. I said, hey, here's a question you might want to post. So she hooked it up, and this is a good one. Voyager 1 was launched in 1977, okay? It contains something called a Voyager Golden Record, which has sights and sounds from Earth. The intent of it is to be discovered by extraterrestrial life someday. Well, there's a song on that record called Dark Was the Night from 1927 on that record. And it's a beautiful, beautiful song. And who is the singer of that amazing song? Well, sadly, none of you answered it. None of you even tried. Come on, God hates a coward. Well, the answer is simple. Blind Willie Johnson. Excuse me. Though Blind Willie Johnson was never a blues player, he's always regarded as a blues player because the guy was an absolute wizard on the guitar. Okay? But Blind Willie Johnson was strictly gospel. And as evidenced on this song from April 20th, 1930, you're going to see how awesome this man was. From his last recording session, April 20th, in the year of our Lord, 1930, the song is called The Soul of a Man, Blind Willie Johnson. You guys see, hear his better half, Angelique, in the background. And, oh, speaking of hotties, look at this one. Adamari Lopez, Babe of the Day. This one. See, she turned 42 years old yesterday. Adamari Lopez was born May 18th, 1971. 42, and damn, is she fine! The soul of a man loves a woe man like this, huh? Oh, yeah. Here we go. I think you're going to enjoy this one. Let me pump up the volume. Oh, it's already pumped up. Bear with his, gravelly vocals. That's just how he was. Wow. Amen. I thank the Lord for good beauty like this and great eyesight as well. This is a gift sent from heaven above right here. Adamari Lopez. Most of you have probably never heard of her. Like I said, I wouldn't have heard of her if it weren't for my better half. I'll never forget her, and I don't think you will either. Good Lord. She almost fell out. Black panties, in case you're wondering. A lucky man right there, eh? That's what I'm thinking. That is a billion-dollar smile. Listen to that guitar. If you like Blind Willie Johnson as much as I do, there's a movie called The Soul of a Man that you need to see, directed by Wim Wenders. You've got to see that movie. I love this picture right here. It shows off her amazing smile. So sweet and innocent and just stunningly gorgeous. What is the soul of a man? Wow. Perfect gospel song, huh? I think so. And for it I could understand. Sorry, some of the pictures are a little small. I thought they were bigger, but it didn't turn out that way. What are you going to do, right? Better to have a small picture than no picture at all. See, I'm an optimist, not a pessimist. But if any of you fans are disappointed by it, then do me a favor. Send me some pictures, would you? Ha ha! I love this picture. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, 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 as is that. Somebody drew on her. Shame on them. But it does says, please don't tell me I look like that prostitute Britney Spears. Ha ha. Way to go, Adamari. This girl's amazing. Like I said, amazing. Stunningly gorgeous. Just natural beauty. You can't get much better than that. Oops. Oh, shit. I just screwed up. My thumb slipped. I started recording something with my phone. Oh, boy. Bear with me, folks. There, we'll get right back there in a moment. There you go. See? We have redeemed ourselves. Thank you, Lord, for redemption. Hey, we got some random facts of the day as I continue showing off Adamari Lopez. On this day in 1995, a real-life Doogie Howser. World's youngest doctor, Bala Murali Ambadi, 17 years old, graduate from Mount Sinai. Wow. On this day in 1994, the final episode of L.A. Law ends their eight-year run. On this day in 1992, the 27th Amendment was ratified, prohibiting Congress from raising its salary. Really? That's not a real amendment. Because obviously if it was, they wouldn't raise their freaking salary. What the hell? Wow! So, 27th Amendment was thrown out the window. On this day in 1992 as well, Amy Fisher shoots Mary Jo Buttafuoco in Massapequa, New York. Yeah, the whole Joey Buttafuoco, Amy Fisher bullshit. Not that I cared about it, because trust me, I didn't. It was a waste of my life watching that shit. Also on this day in 1992, big day that day, Englishman Dave Gowder, 224-pound man, pulled a 196-ton jumbo jet 3 inches. Wow, that's a man right there. Oh! Let's see if we can see the pant. See. Unfortunately, now I was able to see the panty line of her white panties on that, but unfortunately I can't see it here. So you have to find that picture on the old internet that Al Gore invented. On this day in 1991, Willie T. Ribbs becomes the very first black driver to make the Indianapolis 500. We need more African-American and black drivers in racing, in my opinion. I'd love to see that. On this day in 1988, 25 years ago today, and I remember it vividly, the Red Sox retired Bobby Dore's number one. And Bobby Dore, by the way, is now 95 years old, still going strong. On this day in 1982, I can't believe this happened. Sophia Loren, that gorgeous lady, jailed in Naples, Italy for tax evasion. This picture I thought was a lot bigger. It didn't come out that big on my phone, because my phone sucks. On this day in 1965, Patricia R. Harris named the very first United States black female ambassador. Where to? Luxembourg. Beautiful, eh? Beautiful. On this day in 1958, the U.S. and Canada formed the North American Air Defense Command, commonly known as NORAD. What's NORAD most known for? Of course, the Santa Tractor. The Santa Tracker, right? Of course it is. On this day in 1935, the National Football League adopts an annual college draft to begin in 1936. And look how big the NFL draft is nowadays. I love this picture. I think it's amazing. I just wish it was bigger. It was bigger for me on the computer. On this day in 1928, 51 frogs entered the first annual Frog Jumping Jubilee in Angels Camp, California. Leave it to the land of fruits and nuts to have an event like that, huh? Yeah, whatever floats your boat, right?
Damn right, love doctor.
On this day in 1906, the Federated Boys Club of America organizes. On this day in 1900, Great Britain annexes Tonga Archipelago Island. On this day in 1898, the post office authorizes the use of post guides. Way to go. On this day in 1891, Rice Institute becomes, which later became Rice University, is chartered. This one's cool. On this day in 1885, those of you that have shoe fetishes like my love goddess, the first ever mass production of shoes. It was by Jan Matzelinger, Lynn, Massachusetts. Maybe it's Jan. I don't know. Probably. Whatever. There you go. Shoe fetish complied with. Object good. On this day in 1884, Ringling Brothers Circus premieres. On this day in 1865, Confederate President Jefferson Davis is captured by the Union cavalry in Georgia. Georgia, better known as Southern South Carolina. On this day in 1862, the Homestead Act becomes law, providing cheap land for settlement of the West. Yeah, we know how cheap the land is nowadays, right? On this day in 1857, William Francis Channing and Moses G. Farmer patent the electric fire alarm. Way to go, saving many, many lives because of that. Thank you. On this day in 1848, the first department store opens. Yippers! Also on this day in 1848, you Texas folks are going to love this. Mexico gives Texas to the United States, ending the Mexican-American War. And now you know. Texas, a gift. Does that mean it's worthless? No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding, Texans. On this day in 1780, about midday, near total darkness descends on much of New England. To this day, it's still unexplained. Very interesting. I'll have to research that one more. And finally, on this day in 1643, Massachusetts Bay Colony, Plymouth Colony, Connecticut Colony, and New Harbor, they all form the United Colonies of New England. Way to go. Speaking of New England, it is time for some Boston Bruins hockey. Go Bruins! Beat the Rangers! Folks! Empty as the brain cells of an average Yankee fan. You know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make the fetus to head out. So everybody take care of a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill your drink. Or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being the Yankee fan. Or it's dumber than that. It's rooting for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli.
I'm as good as Tom Brady.
Yeah, in your freaking dreams. Manning, or men slapping women, or racism, or animal abuse, or anybody who's associated with, supports, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Adamari Lopez.